The 19th century was a tumultuous time for Jews of Central Europe. They had been granted new freedoms and for the first time were equal to other citizens before the law in most European countries. Yet at the same time, they continued to face bitter and at times violent anti-Semitism from Christians who claimed that Jews were unassimilable into European culture. Amidst the anguish and upheaval, a handful of Jewish scholars of the time looked to early Islam, and particularly the Prophet Muhammad, for inspiration and consolation. In memory of what they saw as a golden age of Jewish culture in medieval Muslim cities, such as Baghdad and Cordoba, Jewish communities in Central Europe built gleaming new synagogues in the Moorish style, looking like mosques with their minarets. I'm John Tolan, professor of history at the University of Nantes in France. For over 30 years, I've been researching the intertwined histories of Jews, Christians, and Muslims in Europe and the Mediterranean world. This video is based on a chapter of my recent book, Faces of the Prophet, A History of Western Portrayals of Muhammad. In this book, I show that while many Europeans, from the Middle Ages to today, had a negative, polemical perception of Muhammad, others looked on him with fascination and admiration. Rabbi and reformer Abraham Geiger sought to usher in innovations in the practice of Judaism in order to facilitate Jews' greater inclusion into an increasingly secular European society and to counter anti-Semitism. Geiger's scholarship on the history of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam was closely related to his reform project. He compared the Jewish traditions of the Bible and the Talmud with the text of the Quran and concluded that Islam was closer to Judaism, truer to the spirit and law of Moses than was Christianity, and that Muhammad was not an imposter. According to Geiger, the Prophet Muhammad seems rather to have been a genuine enthusiast who was himself convinced of his divine mission, and whom the union of all religions appeared necessary to the welfare of mankind. He so fully worked himself into this idea in thought, in feeling, and in action, that every event seemed to him a divine inspiration. For Geiger, Judaism developed its own fullest potential in closest union with the Arab civilization. Islamic civilization is not only friendly to the development of Judaism, it represents a pure, unsullied form of monotheism that can serve as a model for 19th century Jews in their efforts to reform Judaism. Gustav Weil was a fellow student of Geiger's at Heidelberg. The two studied Arabic together. Weil subsequently traveled to Algeria, Cairo, and Istanbul, writing for German newspapers, teaching French, and studying Arabic, Persian, and Turkish. On his return to Germany, he published works on Arabic poetry and German translations of Arabic texts, in particular the Arabian Nights. Among his many studies of the earlier history of Islam was a biography of Muhammad. According to Weil, Muhammad is no imposter, but a sincere reformer. In accordance with Geiger and with many 18th century authors, Weil views Muhammad as seeking to renew the unsullied, original monotheism of the patriarch Abraham. In Weil's account, Islam was a purified version of both Judaism and Christianity. He calls it a Judaism without the many ritual and ceremonial laws, which, according to Muhammad's declaration, even Christ had been called to abolish, or a Christianity without the Trinity, crucifixion, and salvation. Like Geiger, Weil stresses how medieval Muslim rulers allowed Jewish culture to flourish. Nothing better evokes this lost paradise of flourishing Judaism within Islamic culture than the string of Moorish-style synagogues built throughout Central Europe in the 19th century. The legal emancipation of Jews meant, among other things, that they could buy land and build synagogues to serve not only as houses of worship for growing communities, but as prominent symbols of their new place in European society. In the mid-19th century, sumptuous synagogues rose up in Leipzig, Vienna, Budapest, Berlin, and elsewhere, graced with domes, horseshoe arches, elaborate stucco tracery, and towers that looked like minarets. While most of them were subsequently destroyed by the Nazis, the graceful Moorish synagogue of Budapest still welcomes the faithful today. Hungarian scholar and reformer Ignaz Goldseer was a member of that synagogue. From 1873 to 1874, the age of 23, Goldseer traveled to Istanbul, Beirut, Damascus, Jerusalem, and Cairo, where he became the first European enrolled in Al-Azhar, the university in Cairo founded in the 10th century, which is still one of the principal institutions of religious learning in the Muslim world. He sought out and became friends with young Muslim reformers, such as Tahar al-Jaziri in Damascus and Jama'ad-Din al-Afghani in Cairo. Their attempts to reform Islamic doctrine and practice, unite Muslims, and resist British and French imperialism provoked Goldseer's enthusiasm. Muslim reform could serve as a model for Jewish reform. Goldseer portrays Muhammad as the bearer of a universal message of pure monotheism, a simple, rational religion. My ideal, he said, was to elevate Judaism to a similar, rational level. For these authors, thinking and writing about Muhammad and about Islam is inseparable from thinking and writing about Judaism and Christianity. Geiger, Weil, and Goldseer were scholars who sought to understand the origins of Islam, but their concerns about European Jews, about the tensions between tradition and reform, and about assimilation and anti-Semitism were never far from their minds. For these 19th century Jews, the Muslim prophet could serve as a heuristic model for reforming Judaism. This is worth bearing in mind today, as both Jews and Muslims are increasingly objects of hate crimes in the US, Europe, and elsewhere. By building on their common heritage and mutual understanding, Jews, Muslims, and others can help forge a more tolerant society. These are just a few of the often surprising Western portraits of Islam's prophet that I explore in my book, Faces of Muhammad. If you like this video, please share it. Thank you. I'm John Tolan for the Amir Stein Center.